Hi everyone, welcome to the third video on how to use Netconf protocol inside Python script for interacting with networking devices. In the second video we have seen how to get schema of each Yang data model. So there even we have seen how to get a basic understanding on configuration structure of Yang data model using pyang tool. So you can see we have received the configuration tree view of iOS XE native.yang. In this video, we'll see how to get configuration using Netconf. So before we go into Python, we'll see how to get configuration in terminal. First, we need to SSH to device using port 830. 830 is the default port for Netconf. I'll be using my device csr3.test.lab. I'll give the password. Now device will be sharing the capabilities. So now I need to give response hello. Now this is the XML data which I need to transfer for getting the configuration. These I explained in a previous video about Netconf. You can have a look into that. I'll add that video also in the description. So you can see I received complete configuration in terminal. It is in a XML format. You can see some of the details, like I have one route 33.3.3. Sorry, not the route. It is an interface IP address. So gigabit 3 is having IP address 33. So you'll be able to see, and the default route, and all these details you will be able to see here. And when you use it in Python, there are some libraries available which can make it in a proper XML format. So but in this video I'll be showing the minimal code needed for running and getting the configuration. So we'll see how to format it properly in upcoming videos, but here we'll be writing a simple code for getting the configuration. So we'll go to our Atom. I'll create a copy of this. Create the file name. Get config. And here we don't need a schema here, so what we'll delete that. Then inside print, what we'll do, the same manager connection rtr one underscore manager dot, so the method is get config. Then the configuration is going to be running. Let's try running the script. Yeah, you can see here I have received complete configuration of the device, but it is not in a formatted way. There are some libraries available in Python which formats it properly, and you'll be able to read it in a structure. But in this video we'll be using as it is, because I'm showing the bare minimum lines of code required for getting the configuration. There are some online tools available for formatting the XML file what you received. So can that for formatting it for now. I'll give format. So here you can see the configuration, the data which we received from the device. You can see the namespace here. It is iOS XE native, which we have verified earlier. So if you compare this, you can see the software version is under native. If you go to the pyang output of that, This is a pyang output of iOS XE native. You can see under native version. Similar way, the host name also will be under native. We'll verify the host name here. Let's see where it comes. Yeah, we can see the host name here. That is a string. Below that, you'll be able to see other configuration parameters as well. You can see username, and under username, you can see the name, privilege, password. We'll compare it with the data what we received. You can see username, and under that name, privilege, password, name, privilege, and the encrypted password, and all these username will be under this section username. You can see username starts here and ends here for each user. Now we'll minimize this native, and here you can see there are multiple data models available, multiple formats. So we'll expand and see this. This is open configs format. This is also open config, and this is IETF hyphen interfaces, which we have verified earlier. So you'll see the format here. So under interfaces, you can see interface and its name, then type whether it is enabled or not. If we verify this here, this is a pyang output of IETF hyphen interfaces. You can see under interfaces, you can see the interface name, then the type whether it is enabled or not. Now if you see here, the namespace is again IETF hyphen IP. Here under IPv4, we can see the address and netmask. We'll verify that. This is the pyang output of IETF hyphen IP. So under IPv4, address, IP, and subnet mask, netmask. So all these details you will be able to decode it using pyang. So in the next video, we will see how to filter the output. Now we are getting complete configuration. If you just want to get only interface IP or the configured username or the route details, all this we'll see in the next video. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.